It's been a long time coming, on this road I've been running to get in this music game.
Yeah, it's definitely a blessing to be in the position that I'm in right now. You know, being an independent artist out here in California in the music climate that we're dealing with right now. In spite of all the people that I've dealt with and been around and inspired to do music through, it was a great feeling to be able to be an independent artist and get on the radio without their help. Can't nobody say they did it for me. You know what I mean? And that's the blessing through it all. You know, the record that's spinning, you know, I let them pick the record that they wanted to play. And the record that's spinning is actually a song that I wrote and produced myself. And I was being told by all my friends, you know, you don't need to do that. You don't need to do this. You don't need to do that. But when I look back over those conversations, like a lot of those friends that told me that their songs ain't even playing on the radio and they're doing music that's like the trendy stuff that's going on today, and I like some of that stuff, but I don't want a whole album full of trendy songs. I want to be able to bring some of the music back to the fold that I was raised on, you know, some of that good love making music, you know, as well as some of that family reunion music, you know, some of that good music that mama, daddy, grandma, everybody can listen to, as well as being appealing to, you know, some of the younger people out here in the world and give them some true essence. You know, everybody that's young it's just my opinion. I feel like everybody that's young they don't have to be the way everybody else is out here, you know. March to your own beat, create your own lane, you know. If you're doing everything everybody else is doing, you ain't doing nothing special. You're not standing out, you know. Yeah, with that being said, you know, I'm very thankful for the producers that recognized my talent and what I was trying to do as an artist, and they didn't make me stray too far left or right from who I am as an artist. But, you know, it was cool to go in and take some of their ideas and add to what I do to bring the sound for it that we brought for it with the Take It There album, you know. Particularly Sauce, Curtis Sauce Wilson from the group Something for the People. He helped me as far as to channel into that sound and change from what I was doing, the original old school R&B, to bring it to today's R&B with a mixture of yesterday's. I got the boy Cuzzo, Jeffrey Cuzzo Richard, man, that boy, he gave me a record called I Need You and another record called She's Still Here. It was magical when I got in the studio with this dude. I met him and I just knew when I got in there with him that it was gonna be an awesome situation. Cause he's a musician as well as a visionary. He's seen where he wanted this record to go from the beginning. And I caught his vibe and he caught mine and we ran with it. So I'm thankful for that, as well as Sauce, Curtis Wilson's brother Show, who gave me the title track to the album, Take It There. And then he did Good Lovin', which was written by, it's one of the only outside writers that wrote on the record. Freckles, the writer, she wrote Good Lovin'. That was one of the dopest records I've done, you know. And I'm thankful for them brothers. So hopefully as we get things progressing, I can reach back to them and do them a great favor, you know, and be a blessing to them in return, you know. And as well, I want to thank my writing team, Ink Cartel Music, you know, J.R. Hatley, Dion Evans, and Luke Austin. They're some of the most incredible writers and producers you're gonna meet out here. They've got some records out there that have been placed, but they haven't really gotten the just due of the other great people like the Pharrells, the Timberlands, and all them. But trust me, Ink Cartel, we're coming in a big way. So I love them, and we're going to build from this as a platform, and we're going to take it to the next level. Ink Cartel 2014. Yeah, so lot of people told me, you know, it's not good to, you know, you need to do this, you need to do that, you know, and, you know, you're not going to finish, you're not going to do that. I'm like, I'm not marching to your beat no more. I feel like I don't mind finishing last. I'm just going to finish strong. That's what's going on with me right now. It's GB3 Paris, you know, that's what it's about right now. The people that have been in my corner showing me that regardless of what they're doing, you have something great going on over here. You need to exploit it, and let's push it and go all the way. Basically where I'm at right now. I'm not being selfish, but I'm basically on some get it done by all means necessary. Do the things that other people are saying they won't do, you know? And you may get 1,000 people to tell you no. All you need is one person to tell you yes. And when you get that yes, everybody that told you no, they come around eventually. They come back around, you know? And it all works in its favor, you know? You can't be mad at people for not moving the way you want them to move right away, you know? You can't be mad at them for that because it ain't for everybody, you know? But in the end, scared money don't make no money. You know, I put my money where my mouth is, you know? And sometimes I have a big mouth. But I'm humble enough to say when I'm wrong and man enough to apologize if I'm wrong, you know? I think we're on to something great here with this Paris project. We'll take it there. And again, I need all of my people that really love me and love what I've done over the years that want to see me be successful. I need your support. I need you to really turn up the heat with your love and tell everybody about what's going on with me. And I really appreciate that. Yeah, as far as like the behind the scenes people who have played a big part in my life, I have to give some love and let be known that, you know, George Blaine III, you know, Dennis Rosiah, Danny Rosiah, and the Architects of Melody family, and the Cabo Wabo family, giving me that platform to do Blaze the Mic. It's just an awesome feeling, and I feel like everything is working together with building my brand, me as an artist, as a writer, as a producer. I definitely want to capitalize off everything that's been going on thus far, and I don't want to lose momentum. So, as you see a lot of artists, they come out, they have a record that's a little bit of hype, or they'll have one hit, and you don't hear nothing from them again. I don't want to be known as a guy that created one record and that's what he's known from. I want to continue to give great music to the world, you know? And I just wanted to thank them guys for giving me an opportunity to kick the door open, so to speak, to get myself through there. And I want to go all guns blazing at this point and take over the industry, basically.